to wet the whistle. Welcome back and welcome front. So delighted to be in your cheered company this afternoon, as per our lovely tradition, Thursday afternoons, springing into summertime show tunes and melodic melodies. I thought, how lovely to christen in the summer equinox in 2 days. Really, we have 48 more hours of springtime, and then we dip right into the summertime on Saturday for the equinox. Lovely. So welcome, if perchance this is your first time with us experiencing this, so lovely to have you. And if this is a return to, awesome to have you back. So without further ado, and not ado, I would love to present our first selection. Oh yes, and the overture we just heard, just in case you're chiming in now, was the oh-so-awesome overture to The Who, Tommy. The Who? The Who? The Who? The Who? The Who, Tommy. Rock opera musical. Actually, it really pioneered the rock opera musical. As did Queen, perhaps, but as far as for the Broadway circuit, really very much this musical pioneered a genre within a genre of Broadway musicals. So it was relatively short-lived on Broadway, but it was such a treasure, and the entire recording from, I believe it's the 1992 2-3 recording, that's accessible on really on any musical platform, so it'll never rust. So yes, onwards to our first selection. I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven, and by some chance I had brought my dice along, and there I stood, and I hollered, someone fade me, but the passengers, they knew right from wrong. Sit down, you're rocking the boat, people said, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat, and the devil drag you under by the sharp lapel of your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. I sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my fist, and there I stood, nicely passing out the whiskey, but the passengers were bound to resist. For the people said, beware, you're on a heavenly trip. The people said, beware, beware, you'll scuttle the ship. And the devil drag you under by the fancy tie round your wicked throat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, a great big wave came and washed me overboard, and there I sank, and I hollered, someone save me. That's the moment I woke up, thank the Lord, the Lord. And I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And the devil drag you under, with the soul so heavy you'll never float. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. So I believe this, what we just heard, is actually a debut for our program. I don't believe that I performed that for this series before. Possibly, but it's a distant memory if I had. So that That oh-so-bubbly and whimsical number is known as Sit Down, You're Rockin' the Boat. No pun intended there, I don't think. But in any event, it's from Frank Lesser's oh-so-lovable, squeezable Guys and Dolls. And actually, during last week's program, we heard the verbal overture to Guys and Dolls. So onward to our next selection. Heart-throbbing, heart-soaking ballad from Carousel, Rodgers and Hammerstein's Carousel, Carousel. Really, Carousel is just, it's such a very touching musical. I mean, touching in the sense where it really is, I feel, a crossover musical. I feel it could pass or classify as an operetta, because there's virtually very, very minimal spoken dialogue. If anything, they're just speaking on pitch more than singing off pitch, if you will. So it's just, oh man, just from head to toe, soup to nuts, it's just this mellifluous singing, and it's just lovely. So that was If I Loved You. Rodgers and Hammerstein, always hypothetical romantics, always, always. But that's what really, that's what coined them just so unique and unconventional. Unconventionalist for librettists. So onward to our next selection. By Angela Lansbury, who portrayed Auntie Mame in the primitive musical. And incidentally, even though it is certainly a love ballad, but she actually was proposing that ballad to her nephew, So it really could transliterate into any recipient because, after all, it still revolves around affection and unconditional love. So it's just a very unique POV or vantage point. Very unique. So yes, that's a real treasure, that one. And we will onwards to the next selection. Actually, yeah, let's rewind back to Guys and Dolls, shall we? Courtesy of Frank Lesser, composer of Guys and Dolls, Guys and Dolls. Also, just a really such a captivating ballad between actually Skye Masterson and Sarah Brown. So it's a lovely duet that can easily be adapted into a solo piece or even a trio if you're feeling extra creative. And as always, at the conclusion of our program, I'd love to present and share with you some factoids of the Broadway stage. So stay tuned for that. And onwards to our next selection. someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair, to ruin your sleep, to make you aware of being alive, being alive. Someone to need you too much, someone to know you too well, someone to pull you up short, put you through hell, to give you support is being alive, being alive, being alive. Someone you have to let in, someone whose feelings you spare, someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot, is being alive, being alive. Someone to crown you with love, someone to force you to care, someone to make you come through, will always be there, as frightened as you of being alive, being alive, being alive, being alive.
And there's character pattern dialogue.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive, being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me
make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive, being alive, being alive.
So that very charismatic melody is from Stephen Sondheim's Company, a little rekindling reunion. It's, I here. We haven't heard that one in a number of weeks, so delighted to rekindle that for you. And it's also very much of a, it's a professed soliloquy, very much so. And I just adore Company, and I'm sure many of our listeners adore it as well. Onward to our next selection. Also twinning it with Sondheim as well. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move. Where are the clowns? There ought to be clowns. Just when I stop. Again with my usual flair, sure of my lines, no one is there. Don't you love farce? My fault, I feel. Don't bother. Isn't it rich? Isn't it weird? Losing my time in this late in my career. But where are the clowns? There ought to be clowns. So where are those clowns anyways? Well, they could be found in the libretto of Stephen Sondheim's A Little Night Music. And oh, such a lullingly lullaby that always seems to be really and covered by numerous artists over the decades, mainly solo artists, one of whom, Judy Collins. She really popularized it very, very much, and I really rush to recommend her recording of it. It's just, just such a lullaby, and just beautiful. So onward to our next selection, eh?
A time when men were kind, when their voices were soft and their words inviting. There was a time when love was blind and the world was a song and the song was exciting. There was a time, then it all went wrong.
from the unparalleled Les Miserables, I Dreamed a Dream. Also just so captivating. Oh man, just really just, you know, love dub for that one. Beautiful, beautiful. And it really, it's very, I feel that musical is just so timeless that it really enchants everyone's hearts, even since it was on Broadway, and perhaps it'll be revived one of these days. And even if not, just the score alone, you could just play it on vinyl or on CD or even on streaming, and it's just, it really, the relevancy of seeing it on stage, you kind of could maybe forget about for that moment, because it's just so all-encompassing, just from one ear to another. It's just wonderful, beautiful. And onwards to our next selection. In this case, I think we are actually, well, we're actually, well, because Les Mis is literally a revolutionary musical in the historical context, we are now fast-forwarding a few number of decades, actually, to Lionel Bart's Oliva.
Been lonely, then you will.
as he needs me or you. also a really, not just a lovely ballad, like a real, ooh, a real, just, it's just so uplifting, and it just carries so much emotional firecrackers in that number. Wow, it's just really very empowering. As sung by Nancy and Oliver, and actually before we forward to our next selection, a very adoring and very, very special participant of ours, Erwin, is consecrating his birth anniversary tomorrow, the 19th of June. So Erwin, I will actually remain mute for this. I'll allow Stevie Wonder to enchant your heart. This, Erwin, is a very special birthday ballad for you. We're just gonna music the maestro. This is dedicated to Erwinkle in commemoration of your birthday tomorrow. And for those tuning in today or tomorrow or in the upcoming weeks, let's all cheers to Erwinkle for his birth anniversary on June 19th. Tomorrow!
Again, when you know there's nothing winning, but I can hold it in.
anniversary cheer, dearest Erwin, on behalf of all of your pals at the Lyad Center and yours truly. Hope your day tomorrow is really awesome, as awesome as you are. So onwards to our last couple selections for the afternoon. You by the Full Monty, which is more of a contemporary musical, but it actually was adapted from the motion picture The Full Monty, with Robert Carlyle, Tim Roth, amongst all the British cast of characters, really a whole carousel of Brits, and it was just such a charming film and such a charming musical. Charming. That's definitely apropos. And onwards to our finale for this afternoon. And then we'll close with just a couple of departing trivia, just a little bit.
Just thinking about cobwebs and the snow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin and say,
thank you so kindly, anyone tuning in at present or tuning in the future or even just entertaining tuning in. We all so thoroughly appreciate all of our virtual attendees' support, participation. It's really just so heartwarming for all of us on behalf of all of my co-hosts and I. Thank you so kindly. I shall bequeath you with some lovely trivia, some historical Broadway trivia, before we sign off. And let's see, oh, a lot of these are numeral recollection. What year did The Music Man premiere on Broadway? Was it 1947, 1957, or 1957? Well, as always, I'll gladly, hopefully we could cover the answers next week. And what is the name of the English widow in The King and I, in Rodgers and Hammerstein, the numeral twos, King and I? Was the English widow named Anna, Elizabeth, or Rose? Anna, Elizabeth, or Rose? Speaking of debut years, what year did Guys and Dolls debut on Broadway? Frank Lesser's Guys and Dolls. Was it 1945, 1950, or 1955? I'll give you a hint. It was not 85 or 95. Oh, whoops, that's not even one of the options. And for Hello, Dolly, what does Dolly attempt to play matchmaker for? Whom, really? Whom does Dolly attempt to play the role of matchmaker for? Did she attempt to play for Harold, Henry, or Horace? Harold, Henry, or Horace? What musical stars Tracy Turnblad? Was it the musical Hair? Was it the musical Hairspray? Or was it the musical Grease? Now, a little hint, it is a jukebox musical, but so are these three options, choices. So, actually, a little subtle hint, The answer to this is a motion picture that is actually being screened in several drive-in, outdoor drive-in Under the Stars cinemas this summer. They are actually showing, actually I believe all three of these musicals they are showing, but there's one in particular that they're especially showing. And then secondary to that too. And let's see, one more, just so we are not pressed for timing. Who gets drafted in the musical Hair? Speaking of Hair, is it Claude who gets drafted? Is it Frank or is it Stan? Just in reminiscing the premise of Hair, which of these characters gets drafted into the revolution of Hair? Claude, Frank, or Stan? And on that treble clef of a note, once again, thanks a million for tuning in. We are so proud to present our cognitive virtual programming from our screen to yours on Facebook Live, still remaining 6 days a week, which is a treat. So we'll be back tomorrow, 2 time intervals, and Saturday, 2 time intervals, and then Monday, and et cetera, et cetera. So thanks a bunch again, and always bear in mind that life's like a movie, write your own ending, keep believing, keep pretending, and keep safe, extra safe.